Hello everyone. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello. Oh Jesus, let me just try and make the light look nice because I am in a new setting. I am in a new setting and it's having trouble. Okay, there you go. It's having trouble, it's having trouble. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello. It is me. Hi guys, so in today's video, I am in my brother's room. I decided to attempt to film here to avoid the traffic, traffic. His room is on the other side of the house, and as you can tell, it's quite different from mine, aside from the eagle or falcon. Is it an eagle or falcon? I'm not sure. Stickers on the door. He doesn't have anything else going on. He's very like organized and minimalistic and definitely a complete opposite of me. So yeah, his room is very much a reflection of that. So for today's video, I wanted to do like a nice chill video. I haven't done videos like this in a while, and I wanted to do some mic scratching. Is there something on the mic? Or is that just a reflection? Are we seeing something here? Are we seeing something? Oh, that's just the hair from my fluffy mic cover.
This is the Ilia.
headless lash mascara. Now, I got really afraid that I got the wrong shade. Because on the bottom here, it says after midnight. But if you search, like, what mascara Jenna was wearing, like, Wednesday was wearing, it says soft black. And I was like, there's no way, like, is this not black? Like, or is this black and she wore soft black, which makes no sense why they would put not the blackest mascara on Wednesday, right? And then I went on their website and it says soft black and then under it, it says after midnight. So I think that the shade color is soft black, but the shade name is after midnight. I think, I don't know. Like, I'm not sure, but I just know that I got the right one. I got the right one. I've been looking for this mascara for a while now, and there was a picture on this woman's website, and I was eyeing this for 4 weeks to see if somebody would buy it, because it came in a set with the lipstick. I had the lipstick here, I will show you, and she was holding it like this, and it just said like 25 euros, which for this mascara, which is 28 euros to get this mascara plus a lipstick, that's about 20 euros. That was a steal. So I was like, I'm gonna eye this, and I'm gonna see, like, because I wanted to buy something else, but then I was like changing my mind, and then this disappeared off of her story, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna see the next time she starts posting on her story if she has sold this or not. And then I saw it again, I was like, okay, it's not sold, I'm gonna make a run for it. I'm gonna say dips, and I ordered it. And in the picture, I actually asked first, because I don't know if she just has big hands or what, but in her hand, this picture, this mascara seemed so tiny. Like, I just think this lady has like really big hands, because in her hand the mascara seemed that small. So I was like, is that an eyeliner? I was fully expecting this to be a mini mascara. I didn't care, I just wanted to try this, because this mascara is said to be like amazing. This is an award-winning mascara, this right here. After it went viral, after it was found out that it was used in Wednesday, and I'm so sorry, let me get the light. Oh my god, you can just press down. I was like clicking on it. Oh my god, you can just press. I'm an idiot. I'm so sorry, my mom called me, and instead of the pause button, I hit the stop button. Never mind, I'll just edit this video together. I don't even know how long I was filming for. I don't know. Anyways, what was I saying? Where's the mascara? Oh yeah, I don't know. I was saying the how big this mascara was. And yeah, it went viral. Jesus Christ. It went viral. And then I just really wanted to try it. And I finally found it. And I got the Lumina eyeliner. And I got this mascara. I tried it this morning. And I actually really like it. It's like my eyelashes are still lifted. I have a problem where my eyelashes just droop down during the day. But they're actually still lifted. And it looks pretty nice. I'm gonna try two coats, but I'm not gonna do it now, because I need to take my makeup later on. Anyway, because I wanna take a nap. I slept for only like 4.5 hours last night. My fault. I went to bed late. But yeah, here is the brush. If you can hear, there is a hornet right outside this window. Look at the brush. Do you see? It's very interesting, and it's really nice. It is really nice. It has like a comb on one side. Do you see that? It's so nice. I have noticed that the reason why this giant fluffy essence mascara that I'm using currently is not working for me, it's because the wand is not bent. I used to think that the reason why that I don't like bent wands, but actually the opposite. I need a bent wand, the one that's a little bit of a curve. This one has curved bristles. That one has curved bristles. when I sent the package, and I was like, okay, she never messaged me, and I thought that she was gonna send the package today, but she never messaged me about sending the package. And yesterday, yesterday, I was expecting some people to come to fix my internet. Our internet has been really, really slow, and my videos have been taking literally the entire day to upload. I'm not even joking. My last video, I put it to upload at 1 a.m. Oh, God. These things. I put it to upload at 1 a.m. I woke up at 9. I woke up at 9 and it was still not uploaded. 8 hours later, it was still not uploaded. And then it finished uploading at about 11. 11. That's how long it took. And then the next video that I uploaded took 9 hours to upload, which usually they take like an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours max. So that was just really bad, and like our computer was really slow. My mom's laptop was really slow. On the phone, it was really slow. So two repairmen came, not repairmen, two like internet guys. Like I don't know what those people are called, the ones that like work with computers and stuff.
Said like the number you're calling.
mom was like, what? So she called me again, which I have no idea why it said that. Like, I don't know what happened. But she called me and she was like, where are you? Like, the guys are literally like waiting in front of the house. I'm like, what do you mean waiting for the house? Why didn't you tell them to like come and knock on the door? Like, I told them, they said that they were in front of the house. And I was like, okay, I'm leaving. So I like peeked at the door and I'm like, hello. And they're like, oh, hello. And I'm like, they're like, just a second. And they're like typing something on the little, they had like a machine that they measure internet with. I don't even know what it is. But they're like, just a second. I'm like, yeah, should you come in when you're ready? And like, yeah, yeah. So later they like rang the door, but like, just come in. Like, I know you're about to come into my house. Just ring. I appreciate it. It's very polite. I appreciate it. But they came in. They weren't there for like 2 minutes as I was in. I'm like, they're asking me questions like, what's wrong with the internet? How long has it been going on? And I don't, where's your this? Where's your that? And I'm like answering the questions and the doorbell rings. I'm like, what now? Here comes the postman with the package. So yeah, that they surprised me. The package surprised me. And what else surprised me is when I opened the package. When I opened the package, I grabbed the bubble wrap. And as I grabbed the bubble wrap, it just unraveled. And all the three products that I had in there, the little eyeliner, the mascara, and the lipstick I'm about to show you, just fell out into the bag. Tell me why. Tell me why you're a business. Not a business, a person. I guess kind of business. An Instagram business. A person who sells makeup products or fragile makeup products. And you just wrap this thing in a little bit of wrapping paper. Not wrapping paper. Bubble wrap. Bubble wrap. Bubble wrap. And you don't even like tape it. The bag is loose. It's that big. The bubble wrap is that big. Like this makeup. Oops, I'm so sorry. So that's why. But this is the reason why I can't mute my phone. I have to have it with me and I can't mute it because my mom has been calling me because she's having trouble with the computer at work and she has nobody like around because everyone's old. She has nobody to ask for help. And so this lady didn't securely wrap the package, so I received this lipstick. Mind you, when she took a picture, she took the picture like this and set like this in her hands and said like, set this set costs this, and it just said the price. It didn't say anything. It didn't say the shade or anything. Actually, this lipstick was open, so I saw the shade and I was like, ooh, like, it's a pretty lipstick, so I might as well get it because I want the mascara and to get the lipstick, Kylie Jenner lipstick and a mascara for the price that's cheaper than the just the mascara. Why not? So I received this lipstick. The packaging is lovely. I don't have anything from my Kylie Jenner. I have just fakes. It has the little Kylie Jenner like lip logo on top. And it says Kylie around this part of the lipstick. It says Kylie there. And it just says Kylie Jenner, Kylie Jenner, Kylie Jenner around here. The sticker at the bottom is gone. So I was like, what shade is this? So thank God there aren't many colors in the lipstick range with this package. So I was able to figure out that the shade that I have is called Work Mode. And it is the one that I'm wearing right now. It's lovely. Lovely, lovely. I actually ate. And it's still on. It's so smooth. I love this formula. It's actually really good. Now the packaging itself is, this is what's funny to me. This is plastic, right? But this is metal. And what happened was because the package wasn't secure, the lipstick is broken. So yeah, I think that either I have two theories because of what? Either the lipstick broke in the package, like as it was getting sent to me, or the lipstick was already broken and she was selling it for cheap in a set because it was broken, but she didn't say that it was broken. Usually these websites, not websites, Instagram accounts that sell these products always say, like, for example, they say, like, why is this Dior lipstick so cheap? Oh, because it's the tester packaging, so it has the tester cap, which is like a little white cap instead of the original, like, big, like, actual, like, plastic, or metal black cap. So yeah, or it says, oh, this is on a discount because it got damaged while putting the lid on it, so it got like a little scratch on the top, which to me is ridiculous. I got so many products for super cheap because they had a scratch on them. Like, that's nothing. Like, just a scratch. Like, I swatched lipstick once and the scratch is gone and it looks brand new. So yeah, that's a benefit for me. But the one thing, I always let the seller know when my package has arrived, because that's just the right thing to do. You tell them that it's arrived so that they can just be like, okay, arrived, good, we're good. Because I don't want to seem cruel, and I don't want to seem like I'm ignoring the seller. So I'm like, yeah, the package arrived. So I tell her, like, oh, the package arrived, but the lipstick is broken. But the lipstick was broken, and I just said, never mind, I can fix it. Like, thank you very much. That's what I said, right? So instead of like replying, oh, good to know, I'm so sorry about the lipstick, or just something like that, I understand. You guys, I understand that some of you might be like, oh, why did you tell her the lipstick is broken? If it doesn't matter to you, you didn't even have to tell her that the lipstick is broken. And I didn't. But I just had a feeling that I should let her know, because I think that she knew that she didn't package this well. Like, who packages lipstick like that? And like, she didn't try to defend herself. And I think she saw the message. It said, seen. She didn't reply at all. Not one bit. And she changed the picture on her account. And the one thing that I know about these accounts is that when they get a customer that's not completely pleased, in order to prevent them from repurchasing or telling other people about them, they change the picture and the name. And I'm pretty sure that this lady, on the day that I told her like the lipstick came broken, she changed the picture of her account and she changed the name. Like, the name stayed the same, but it had like an underscore, right? Is that what it's called? And she removed it. Another thing, if you are looking to buy something from an Instagram profile and you don't know if it's legit or not, let me tell you how you can know if it's legit or not. You go onto the account, you click on the three little dots in the corner. I believe it's the right, selling more